Okay, so in this video we'll be talking about rulers and tapes. So we'll be going through the process on how to read the measurement on a pole push rule. So but first we have some theories here. So we will define first a pole push rule. Okay, so this is the appearance of the pole push rule. Okay, so we have the definition here, no? Rulers and tapes. A roller is one of the most common measuring instruments, so it comes in many sizes and shapes depending on what it is needed for. The yardstick is a long roller, and a measuring tape is yet another type of roller made of flexible cloth or metal tape. Each may look different but are used essentially the same way. Okay, so a ruler, so it is one of the most common measuring instruments, so it comes in many sizes. Also we have also the yardstick, you know, the yardstick. Usually the yardstick will measure up to 1 meter, and the most commonly used now is the tape, no? It come in the flexible cloth, which are used by the seamsters, no? The tailors. And for us the electricians, we will use the metal tape or the pole push rule. Okay, so a ruler or a rule is an instrument used in geometry, technical drawing, and engineering, building to measure distances and or to rule straight lines. Strictly speaking, the ruler is essentially a straight edge used to rule lines and calibrated instrument used for determining measurement, which is called a measure. However, common usage is that a ruler is a calibrated straight edge that can be used for making measurements. So usually we will use the ruler or a rule in making straight edges, but the most common use of a roll tape or a pole push rule is to make measurements of length. Okay, so we have now the pole push rule reading, no? So first we go to the English system, no? But we will have first this view of the roll tape, no? The pole push rule. So here above this one is the English system. So this is the zero, no? Usually the zero is covered by the metal strap here, no? The 0 inch, no? Then we have the 1 inch, 2 inches. Now we have the graduations here, this one, the small lines, no, in between the numbers, no, the big numbers. So those are the graduations, no. So for each graduation there is a value. So below is the metric system or the SI system. So every number is in centimeter, then every graduations here are in mm. So for example, this one line here that is equivalent to 1 mm. So we will go this one by one. First we will go to the English system, so by 2. So if your pole push rule is divided into 2 lines, no, so we have here 0, 1, 2. So this one will be 1/2, the next will be 1 inch, then you have 1 1/2 inch, then 2 inches, 2 1/2 inches, 3 inches. So if we are going to go back to our roll tape here, so this bigger line here on the exactly half, no, of the distance between 0 and 1 here, that is 1/2. So this one also is the exact half, that is read as 1 1/2 inches. Okay, then we will now go to by 4, no, by 4. So we have the distance between 0 to 1 is divided into 4. So we have the first line will be 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, and 4/4. Then the same width, 2 inches and 3 inches. So this will be 1 1/4. Then we have 1 2/4. Then 2/4, you could simplify 2/4 into the Swiss term. So 2/4 is equivalent to 1/2. So that's why we have here 1 1/2. Then 2 1/4, no. So this is also 2 2/4, and that is 2 1/2, no. So this is by 4. Okay, we have by 8. So the 1 inch is divided into 8, no, 8 graduations. So we have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So this will now be read as 0, 1, 8, 2, 8, 3, 8, 2, 4. Now your 2, 4, that is, not 2, 4, but 4, 8, no? 4, 8. So your 4, 8 can be, get into the lowest form, which is equivalent to 1 half, no? 5, 8, 6, 8, 7, 8, 8, 8, will equal to 1. Then we have, this one is 1 and 1, 8, 1 and 2, 8, then so on and so forth. Next is by 16. Now when we say by 16, it is divided into 16 graduations. So from 0 to 1, that is 16 graduations or 16 lines. 1 to 2 is still 16. So that is by 16. So each one is read as 116. Then this is 216, 316, 416, 516, 616, 716, 816. 8 over 16, if you will get the lowest term of that, that will be 1 half, no? Then 9-16, 10-16, 11-16, 12-16, that is 3/4, no? The lowest term for that. Then 13-16, 14-16, 15-16, and 16-16. Okay, so that is by 16, no? Okay, so again, if it is by 16, the graduations, no, between 0 and an inch is divided into 16 lines. Okay, we will continue to by 32. Okay, so the graduations, so the number of lines between 0 to 1 inch, or the an inch is divided into 32 lines or 32 graduations. So we read this one as 1, 32, 2, 32, 3, 32, 4, 32, up to 32 over 32, or equivalent to 1. No? So this one is by 16. So as we can see, if we were going to count this one, it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So this is by 16. So that's why this one is 1 and 13, 16. Because this is the 13th line, no? The 13th line from your 1. So you read the 1, then the line, then the number of graduations, or the number of lines. So that is 1 for 1 inch, 13 for the 13th line here, over 16 for the number of graduations, or the number of lines that this 1 inch here, or this inch here, is divided into. Okay, so this is 2, no? 2 inches. Then we have the second line, so that is 2 also, over 16, because we have 16 graduations. Okay. So let's try to have this one. No? So we have for number 1, no? Maybe I will have this one on a writing pad, no? So that we could have a writing pad. Okay. So we just adjust first our screen. Okay. Oops. Okay. Okay, I believe that our screen has been adjusted. Let's just look for the slide. Okay, we have this one. Try this. Okay, we have now this one. No, okay, so try this. No, so for number 1, let's call out here our pen. Okay, for number 1, okay, this one, this is 32 graduations. No, it's indicated here. This is 1, 2, will use my here, so this will be 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So this is 10. So we could write this one as this number 1, the measure for that one is 10 over 16. Now if you are going to have this one on lowest term, so you could not 16 but 32, sorry for that, because we have 32 graduations. Just erase that one. It will be 10 over 16, no? So if you divide this one by 2, no? 2 divide 2. Okay. Why am I still writing 16? Not 16, but 32. No? There is something on that 16. Okay, so you just, this is 10 over 32 inch, no? We'll divide this one by 2. Okay. So that will be equal to, this is 10 divided by 2, that will be 5. And 10 divided by 2, that will be 16. So this is now the measure, 5 over 16 inch, no? or we could also have also 10 over 32, so that is equivalent to the graduations here. But if we are going to have the final measure, then we will have that one on the lowest term, which is 5 over 16. Now for number 2, no, number 2, so this will be 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, and 26. So your number 2, maybe we could write it this one here now. For your number 2, that will be 26 over 32. Okay, then you divide that one by 2. So you will have 13 over 16. Okay, then you must remember here that this is 7, no? 7. So meaning this is 6. So for our number 1, this must have here 6, no? Before the actual measurement or the 5 16. So this will be 6 and 5 16. This is also 6, so that will be, this will be 6 also, no? 6 and 13 16. Okay, next, number 3, no? Number 3, we got our number 3 here. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we have 13 over 16 because we have 16 graduations here. So that will be 7 and 13 over 16 inches. No? I forgot to write the unit. Okay, for number 4, okay, number 4, that will be 8, no? Because it is already 8 here, and 2, 16. Then we could get the lowest term for 2 over 16 here, divide that one by 2. Then we have 8, and that will be 1, 8, no? 8 and 1, 8. Okay, for number 5, so that is 9. No? I believe that this is still 16, no? We just cut the tape here, no? So this is 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 9 and 7 over 16 inches. So the 7 is not divisible by 2. So this is now your lowest term. Okay, and this is now your final measure. Okay, so let's try another one, no, before we proceed to the metric system. Okay, so we have now this one. Maybe we should move our measure here. Okay, so for number 1, we have, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 over 32, and this is 9 inch here. So 9 and 10 over 32, no? Then you could divide 10 over 32 by 2, no? So they are both divisible by 2. Okay, so you will end up with 5 over 16. So your final measure is 9 and 5 over 16 inches. Okay, so for number 2, so I believe this is 26, no? 32, 31, or maybe we should have the number 4, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 26. So this will be 9 and 26 over 32. So this, the 26 over 32 is divisible by 2. So you will have that one in 13 over 16. So your final measure is 9 over 13, 16 inches. No? Then for number 3, this will be 1. So 16 graduations. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So you have that one as, so the number before this reading here is 10. So you will have that one as 10 and 13 over 16 inches. Okay, for number 4, we will write our number 4 here. So number 4, that is 11 and 2 over 16 inches. Or you could divide this one by 2, no? The 2 and 16. So your final measure is 11 and 1/8 inches. And the fifth one, this is 1 foot. So 1 foot is equivalent to 12 inches, no? Or you could check this one, this one here by 11, then the next number for 11 will be 12, no? So we have 12 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, no? So we could write this one, so we'll just write the two notations for the measures of this one, no? So you cut this one as 1 foot, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 over 16 inches, or you could write this one as 12 and 7 over 16 inches, no? So either of this one will be correct. Okay, now let us proceed to, I believe, metric, no? So metric system. Okay, so the metric system is, like I said, the numbers that can be shown from our tape here. So let's go back to our tape. This one, these numbers represent centimeters. So you have 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 5 centimeters, no? So that is the representation of the numbers, no? Okay, now for the lines here, no, the lines, so this one here, so for every line is equivalent to 1 millimeter, so it is equivalent to 1 millimeter. So for example, this one here, so this one here, this is from 0 to 1 centimeter, so that is, this line here is 9 mm, no? Okay, so that's why for this one, this is 80 mm, no? The reason for that one that is 80 mm is that from 0 here to this 8 here, we have 80 lines, or so that is equivalent to 80 mm, because a line on the metric system, on this tape, no, the metric part, on the metric system part of our tape, is equivalent to 1 mm. Okay, so let's go back to the where is that, the metric system. Okay, so for this one, no, so this is 3 mm, no, this is 3 mm, so this is 7 mm, because from 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 no 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so 7 mm. For this one, this is 16, no, because from 0 to this point, so this is already 10 here, because the in our tape, the centimeter is divided into 10 lines, or 1 centimeter is divided into 10 lines, which each line is equivalent to 1 mm. So you could say that for this one, so write this one here as a note, no, for this one, 1 centimeter is equivalent to 10 mm. Okay, then for this one, this is 16, so that we say 16 because this is 10, then 1 2 3 4 5 6, so that's 16, or 1 and 6 mm. Now if we want to have only a uniform unit, no, 1 cm and 6 mm, that is not a uniform because we have a cm and an mm, so we could have this one in centimeter, so this will be equivalent to 1.6 cm, because also from this relationship, no, we could say that 1 mm is equal to 0.1 cm. okay, so for this one, we have already here 1 cm, then 1 2 3 4 5 6, we could read that one as 1.1 0.2 0.3 0.4 0.5 0.6, then you add that one by 1 cm, so you have 1.6 cm. For this one also, this is point, we have this one, this line here. Okay, maybe we should use the arrow, no? So this one here, that is 2 cm and 2 mm, or 22 mm, because from here to this line, we have 22 lines, so that is 22 mm. If you had to have that one all in centimeter, so we could just write that one as 2 for this one, 0.1 0.2 0.2 cm. okay, so that is how you are going to read the metric part of our pull push rule. Okay, so maybe we will have, so this is also another example, no? So we have 8 cm and 4 mm. Okay, because this is 8, this is 4, or we could have that one as 8.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. So 0.4 cm. This is 9.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6. So 9.6 cm. This is 10.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. Oh no, 0.3. So 9.3 cm. Now also your 10 cm, no? Your 10 cm, that is 10 cm is equivalent to 0.1 meters, no? 0.1 meters. So this one is not 9 but 10, no? Sorry for that. So this is 10. So for this one, we could say that this measure here is equivalent to 0.1, no? Because we have already 10 here. Then we still have 2 numbers here, 0, 3 meters. Okay, so that is how you are going to read these measurements here. Okay, so we now go to an example. Okay, let's try this one. Okay, so we have this, no? So for this one, so we will have this one. This is 18, no? 18. Okay, we should use this one. This is 18, no? So that will be, if we were going to read this one in millimeter, so this is 18 centimeter, so this will be multiplied by 10, no? So that will be equal to 180 millimeter. So we have 180, 181, 182, 183, 184, 185, 186, 187. So our number one is 187 millimeter, or we could have that one in centimeter, 18.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7. So this will be also 18.7 centimeter. Okay, for number 2, so 19, no? 19 times 10, that will be 190 millimeter, plus 1, 2, 3, 4, so that is 194 millimeter, or 19.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, or 19.4 centimeter. For number 3, we have 20 times 10, it will be 200, so we have 200 millimeter, 201, 202, 203, 204, it will be 204 millimeter, or 20 centimeter. So 20.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, or 20.4 centimeter. For number 4, so we go back to 19, so 19 is 190 plus 1, that will be 191 millimeter. Okay, or in centimeter, that will be 19.1, so we have 19.1 centimeter. Okay, so the last one is number 5, so that is 190 millimeter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so that is 198 millimeter, and for centimeter, that is 19.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, so that is 19.8 centimeter. Okay, we could also have this one in meters, no? For number 1, okay, we just base on the centimeter. So this is 18.7. So we know that 10 is 0.1. So this is already 18. So we have 0.1. Then you just copy the remaining number, 187 meter. Number 2, so 19.4. So 10 is 0.1. So we have 0.1. Copy the remaining number. For number 3, that is 20, no? 20. So 10 is 20, 10 is 0.1 meters, so 20 centimeters must be 0.2. So that is 0.2, then copy the remaining number, meters. No, this is not centimeter, but meters. So number 5, that will be, number 4, that will be 0.191 meters. And for number 5, so we run out of space, so maybe we could move this one. Okay, so for number 5, no, in meters. Okay, so that is, okay, so the number 5, that is also 0.198 meters. Okay, so this is now all the answers, no, of our example here. So how about we have one more? Okay, so we have here, so for this one we will get the measures in millimeter, centimeter, and meters. Okay, so first we have number 1, no, maybe we should move our example here. Okay, let's see. Okay, okay, so we have number 1. Okay, so this will be 26, no, because it's 27. 26, 27, and 28. So we have 26, no? 26 times 10, no? 26 times 10. That will be 260, no? 260. So this is already 260 mm. We have 61, 62, 63, 64. So for number 1, that is 264 mm. If we will do that one in centimeter, that will be 26.1.2.3.4. So this will be 26.4 centimeter. In meters, so we know that 20 is 0.2. So that will be 0.264 meters. Okay? Number 2. Okay. So number 2, 27. So 27 times 10, that will be 270. 271, 72, 73, 74, 75. So we have 275 mm. In meters, that will be 27.1.2.3.4.5. That is 27.5 centimeters. In meters, so we just have 0.2 because that is 20 centimeters. No, 20 centimeters is 0.2 meters. Then we just copy the remaining number, 75. No, meters. Okay, number 3. So that is 28 times 2, that will be 280, 281, 282. So we have 282 mm. For centimeter, that is 28.1.2. So we have 28.2 centimeter. For meters, so 0.2. Then copy the remaining number, meters. Okay. Number 4, so we have 27, no? Times 2, that will be 270. Times 10, no, that will be 270. 27 times 10, that will be 270. Then we have 1 here, so that will be 271 meters. For centimeter, we have 27.1. So that will be 27.1 centimeters. And for meters, we will have 0.271 meters. No, 271 meters. Okay, so there is a computation for this one, no? So if you want to convert centimeter to meters, you just divide that one by 100. If you want to convert millimeter into centimeter, you divide that one by 10. So there is a separate video for this one, no? The conversions of different units, no, but for this one we just base on the readings of our pole push rule. Okay, so this is somewhat a shortcut because you are not required to make any mathematical computations, no, in order to convert our measurements from mm, centimeters, and meters. So the last one, no, the fifth, that will be 270, no, 270, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 278, no, meters. Millimeters. For centimeters, 27.1.2.3.4.5.6.7.8. So 27.8 centimeters. And for meters, it will be 0.278 meters. Okay, so we have now here the measurements for the given pole push rule. Okay, So I hope you learned something in this video. So thank you for watching, and as always, enjoy learning.